I shall take a close look at Newton's third law of motion, which often confuses students in its applications. We start with the statement of third law. To every action, there is always an equal and opposite reaction. In all cases, the action and reaction forces act on different bodies. Suppose we consider two spherical particles separated by a distance. I number these particles as 1 and 2 for quick reference and join their centers. So whenever the particle 1 exerts a force on particle 2, let me show this force with this green arrow, and I call this force as F21. 2 reacts by exerting another force on particle 1, and that is this force here, and I'm calling the force as F12. Here the subscript 21 on F means on 2 by 1. Similarly, here the subscript 12 means on 1 by 2. By Newton's third law, these two forces form an action-reaction pair. They are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, and they act along the same line joining the two particles. Therefore, in vector language, the vector F12 is equal to the negative of the force F21. I'll be using a bold font to represent any vector like force as in this case. The pair of action-reaction forces act irrespective of whether the particles involved are at rest or in motion. The pair of action-reaction forces act irrespective of whether the particles touch each other or are separated by a distance. Action-reaction forces begin to exist together and cease to exist together. The pair of action-reaction forces have a mutually reciprocal relationship. You can consider either of these two forces as the action force and the other as the reaction force. And finally, as the statement of third law says explicitly, that the pair of action-reaction forces always act on two different bodies and do not cancel each other out. Because if they were to act on the same body, the net force on the body would have been zero and the body could never have an acceleration. Now, we are ready for the first example, a block resting on a table. Here is a table, a block is sitting on it, and I also show part of the earth, just a representative figure. So let us examine the forces acting between the block and its surroundings. The earth exerts a force of gravity on the block in the vertically downward direction. We call that force as Fg. As a reaction, the block also exerts an equal and opposite force on the earth. So this force on the earth has the same magnitude as Fg, but this is acting upwards, opposite direction. So I'm calling it minus Fg. Similarly, the table also exerts a vertically upward normal force N on the block, and in response, the block exerts a downward force of the same magnitude onto the table. So I might call this force as minus N. Once I show these two pairs of action-reaction forces, let us now draw the free body diagram for the block that shows only the forces acting on the block and ignore the other forces. So here we go, showing the block again in isolation. On the block, the forces acting are Fg, the force of gravity given by the earth, and the normal force given by the table. We do not show the force minus Fg acting on the earth or minus N acting on the table, because in an FBD, we only show the forces acting on the block. So to write this equation of motion, I choose the upward direction as positive, and recalling second law, that is F is equal to ma, we can write down then the upward direction, the net force acting on the block is normal force upwards, positive, gravity force downward, therefore negative. So I have got N minus Fg as the net force. This must be equal to mass of the block M into acceleration. But since the block is at rest, its acceleration in the vertical direction is zero, M into zero, which is giving me simply zero. So N is equal to Fg, but this force of gravity is the product of mass M and the free fall acceleration g. So that's the result we have got. We are getting that the normal force acting on the block is equal in magnitude to the force of gravity and they're in opposite direction. Sounds a bit like third law statement. Feeling tempted to call them action-reaction pair. Wrong. Read the third law statement once again. To every action, there is always an equal and opposite reaction. In all cases, the action and reaction forces act on different bodies. So in this case, since the normal force N and the force of gravity Fg are acting on the same body, the block, they can never be action-reaction pair of forces. Actually, we got N and Fg are equal and opposite by using second law, that is F is equal to ma, and not from the third law. When a dog pulls a sledge, by Newton's third law, the sledge must also pull the dog with an equal and opposite force. Then why does the sledge move at all? I shall draw a simple diagram. This is the ground, and here is a sledge, and here is a dog. There is a belt which joins the sledge to the dog's collar, and we shall assume the mass of the sledge is capital M, the mass of the dog is small m, and this sledge plus dog system is moving towards right on your screen with an acceleration of A. Let me show here the acceleration vector with this red arrow. So let us identify all the forces which are acting between the sledge and the dog and between the sledge dog system and its surroundings. First, you note that the dog exerts a force of pull on the sledge through this belt. I'm calling this force as F. And as a reaction, the sledge also exerts an equal but opposite force on the dog along the same line. This force will be minus F. Since the mass of the dog is small m, the earth exerts a force of gravity on the dog, which is mg, acting vertically downwards. As a reaction, the dog also exerts a force of equal magnitude but upwards on the earth. Similarly, for the sledge, since the mass is capital M, the earth exerts a force of gravity on the sledge, which is capital M into g. Here g is the free fall acceleration. And in response, sledge also exerts an upward force of equal magnitude on the earth. Next, the dog with his hind leg exerts a contact force onto the ground slightly backwards at an angle. If I can show that force, this contact force given by the dog's leg onto the ground at an angle to the left of downward vertical, I call that force as R1. As a reaction, the ground gives an equal but opposite force onto the dog minus R1. Let me resolve these two forces, R1 and minus R1, this is an action-reaction pair, into their normal and frictional components. So R1 components are N1 and F1, and minus R1's components are minus N1 and minus F1. Similarly, come to the sledge. The sledge exerts a contact force onto the ground at an angle slightly forwards. This is the force R2, contact force given by the sledge onto the ground at an angle slightly right of the downward vertical. So, in reaction, the ground also gives a force on the sledge. That force will be minus R2. R2 and minus R2 form an action-reaction pair. Like in this case, we resolve the forces into their normal and frictional components. So, R2 components are N2 and F2, while minus R2's components are minus N2 and minus F2. Since we are interested here in the motion of this sledge plus dog system, we should only consider the forces acting on this system, that is on the sledge and on the dog. And we should ignore all the forces acting on the ground or on the earth. Therefore, let me take this out, R2 or its components. Here also R1 or its components, because they are acting on the ground. We don't need them. Similarly, the reaction forces to these forces of gravity exerted by the dog and by the sledge on the earth, which are not shown in my figure, are also ignored. We are only interested in the forces which you can see now on the sledge plus dog system. For the dog, this upward component, normal force minus N1, balances the force of gravity, mg. So there is no vertical motion for the dog. Similarly, for the sledge, this upward normal force minus N2 cancels out the gravity force. So there is no vertical motion. These forces of pull between sledge and dog, F and minus F, they cancel each other out. We are only left with a frictional force minus F1 acting on the dog towards the right, and a frictional force minus F2 acting on the sledge towards the left. So if we take a positive x-axis in the rightward direction, we understand here that here is a force of magnitude F1 causing the motion for the system towards right, and a force of magnitude F2 acting to the left resisting the motion. So we have got an equation of motion for the system in the x direction, which is F1 minus F2 net force towards right is equal to total mass of system capital M plus small m into the acceleration A. And from it follows that the system's acceleration is F1 minus F2 upon capital M plus small m, where once again F1 is the magnitude of frictional force exerted on the dog by the ground, F2 is the magnitude of frictional force exerted on the sledge by the ground, capital M the mass of sledge, and small m is the mass of the dog. And that's the way the system moves forwards towards the right.